Ghanaians are opening up to the idea of the new ones running the scene and doing what they love.
The new wave of musicians were told is that nobody's gonna like this music. There's no way. And what we have done is sort of create the soundtrack for the youth.
It's cold in Ghana, like, can't you see?
Pretty girls to my left and my right, but see we don't flock. Told her with her, we don't stop. Would I wear the figure, say we up in here, they count our shots. We don't even slap no shots. Lame and them wait in line. We cannot waste no time. Long as we active, we can't tolerate all fines. We over gas all eyes. The crazy my summer move.
Kids I was around in high school were all like making music, but everybody was making music on their laptops. So when I moved from America and went to high school in Ghana, that's actually where I discovered you can record yourself and you can make your own beats like on a laptop. My mom is sort of like the soul aspect of where I got my music influence from. My dad is very like polar opposite. My dad loves soul and funk.
Ike and Tina Turner. Have you heard of Ike and Tina?
Back then was the typical Ghanaian style music. Osibisa, they were very special. They had international exposure. So they also brought a completely different style of Afro music. The local band started copying them, and then High Life took over.
I'm making my own music, the Ghanaian High Life, indigenous way, yeah, yeah, yeah.
My music deals a lot with like sexual tropes and like sexuality within women, and it's kind of unapologetic about that. Defying the status quo of what is African was a big theme in my image and in my music as well.
I'm feeling so
being an alternative artist is quite difficult because a lot of people will tell you, like, you know, we don't think the masses can consume it. We don't think that people will like what you do because it has too much of foreign influence. So it's challenging, but you still continue to push the boundaries. I think King Promise is really interesting. I like how he's marrying R&B and High Life together.
Music is life. And all this is because of like the music I grew up with, which is High Life. When I started making music fresh, I wanted to be one of the best songwriters. I didn't want to just sing. I just wanted to make sure that like it was a total package. So in the songwriting, the delivery, the voice, everything, I try to have it on point. There's a little bit of like Ghanaian music influence and Western music influence. Regardless of the kind of sound I'm working on, the kind of beat or whatsoever, I make sure there's the Ghanaian influence in there. Because that's what we have and they don't have. It was crazy, like, I had no money. That's why I thought it's smart. I'm like, you know what? Be friends with the producers and then you get, you know, studio time for, you know, a lesser fee or even for free. Even having people listen to the music, it was really, really hard. Like, I had to, like, go to a radio station, like, with my CD. I'm like, you guys, you need to listen to this. I go out and then people come to the concerts and you see them singing word for word, and some of them are like white, and some of them I'm like, oh, do you not understand what you're singing? It's beautiful, like it inspires me to even go harder for the fans. Friends always kept supporting the movement. It was just a matter of time, you know. When it was meant to happen, it did happen. It's beautiful to see what's happening in Ghanaian music right now. And the world is like loving it.
Nothing, live that for tomorrow, me. Yeah, yeah. Nobody go come help you, the whole thing. I should not say that, so how I just kill yourself.
Accra.
Accra.
Stay with greatest
city.
Greatest
city.
Don't let nobody lie to you.
Yeah, we live free. We are unique, and that's what makes us different.
You got that thing where I need, come over here, make you see,
about the place where I'm mad up. Two shots to the head, make I'm mad up. We run things, we come mad up. Booty girls, body place, make I'm mad up.
We shop a lot, and this is where we get all the thrift stuff. This is where all the less privileged kids get all their clothes and everything. And then we are here to let all the kids know that, yo, it's okay to come and shop in Kathmandu.
Because that's where all the thrift shop is from.
So don't let anybody lie to you. Over there in America, they have shops like this. And the kids shop there. You can shop here. Because all the drifts are here.
Check this out.
Drift on that. Drift on that.
Accra is not easy.
Accra is not easy.
In Accra is not easy.
It's tough, but it makes you.
There's not a lot of money in the system already, so it's not that people don't want to pay the value of your talents. They don't have enough to pay the value of your talents. We're always compromising or like negotiating down and stuff. So like, you just have to figure it out one way or the other. Yeah.
Survive.
Before we drop Lamem Tape 1, we created a page and we tweeted that our first single drops when we get 1,000 followers. Yeah, on the day of release, we had like 1,000 and something followers. And then we dropped the tape. And the response was crazy. Like, we didn't expect it. Like, a week later, it dropped in the stores and we were number one in Ghana.
Me personally, I'm not too much into political.
We don't know that it affects us, but at the end of the day, it does. Like, at the time Stone Island came out, I didn't know that was what it was going to do, but all of a sudden, it just ended up promoting this whole brotherly love in Ghana. And the way the Ghanaian culture is set up, like, you can't just hug your brother just like that without people looking at you sus. But all of a sudden it was big, like all the boys, no one cared anymore.
Shouts to all my bros, all my niggas on the road. Bitch, I'ma fuck with the sauce, night niggas acting cold. I love all my bros, 100 niggas on the road.
I don't think like you need to know how. It's more about like how ambitious you are and how much you want it and just never stopping, basically.
To me, what is most important is really impacting the globe with that sound and having collaborators that are just as willing to push the boundaries and just as willing to push themselves.
I'm thinking, okay, cool, the next 5 years, when you ask anybody who's your favorite African artist, they don't need to think twice, they need to take in promise. That's the plan. You were like a ticking bomb. It's just about to blow up, and you know, it's beautiful to be a part of it.